And he joins us now. So great to have you here.
It's lovely to be here. Yeah. I always love this country. It's a very easy thing to say, but there's something about Australia. I remember walking out of the Four Seasons in Sydney about 3 years ago, and I realised I feel more comfortable here than I do in England. I don't understand it.
We should just move.
Yeah. And it's very strange, because when I was a kid, I was obsessed by the Ashes, but I was an Australia supporter.
Oh.
So I knew all about Woodfull and Ponsford and Bradman and Kippax and Oldfield and Bill O'Reilly and Clary Grimmett. I knew all about these tests that had been played in the 30s. And then when I was 13, I changed my allegiance back to England.
Oh.
It was strange. Though. Well, why?
We'll have you back.
Yeah.
Are you supporting the series at the moment?
Oh, yes.
Well, why did you leave your home country?
Money.
Money. Right, yeah. Well, that checks out completely.
If I could get paid for watching cricket on television, I'd be a very happy
man. Hey, let's talk about the show you are doing while you're here. I love this. An Evening with the Late John Cleese.
Well, I died about 6 weeks ago. You didn't read about it?
No.
Oh, it was big. It was a big story in England. Yes, I died, and then I rose on the third day. I needed a little bit more money.
Yes, of course.
So I came to ask for a tour.
How did you know you were dead?
I couldn't get up in the morning. No, and I checked the obituary column, yes, and I was in it.
Really?
What did it say?
It's quite a nasty feeling.
What did your obituary say?
You think, oh, I didn't know I was dead. And then what happens is that people behave as though you're not there.
Really?
Oh, yes, I said to my wife, hello, good morning, and she just looked straight through me.
Oh.
Wow.
I think that's just marriage. Now, the last time you were on, you said that you were associating with academics who had evidence of an afterlife.
Yes, well, I've been interested in this for a long time because I think that scientists know less than they think. Mm. I think there's a whole lot of stuff going on that they can't explain and that they sort of want to sweep under the carpet. And the people that I know, mainly academics, so several of them, for example, Virginia University, University of Virginia, who've been studying this kind of thing. It's a very, very interesting matter. And you don't get much about it on television or in the papers, except in a slightly sensational way, you know. And it's also got religious connotations. And it's not that. It's a scientific matter.
So what evidence do you have of it?
Well, you take out-of-body experiences. There are people who have out-of-body experiences when they leave their body, sometimes during an operation, and they observe what's going on, and sometimes they even leave and go somewhere else.
Right.
And then come back, and afterwards, when they reunite with their body, they have information that they couldn't possibly have had unless they'd had an out-of-body experience. There's an extraordinary story about a Hispanic in America who was in a ward for something, and she just mentioned to the nurses, she said, oh, I had an out-of-body experience. And the nurses are interested, the doctors aren't. Right. But the nurses are, and they said, well, tell more. And she said, well, I went around the outside of the building. There's a tennis shoe on the windowsill on the other side. So one of the nurses went and checked, and there was a tennis shoe, and you couldn't see it from the ground. Wow. So how did she know it was there?
Oh. So have you ever...
If she has, you see, what it means is that this brain is not creating consciousness. It's more like a television set. And the program's not being made in the set. The program is picking the television set is picking the program up and making it transferable
it's
to
this.
You.
So maybe the brain is this an out of body experience right now? This could be right now.
Oh, this isn't happening. Does
really? Okay, so you're dead. This isn't on air. What's going on?
But actually, if you look at the evidence, and not the sensational stuff, but the academic stuff, there's a lot of things that that contemporary science can't explain. And they're rather dishonest about it, I think, because they sweep it under the carpet and they say it's rubbish. But actually, there's very good academic research that suggests that it's the best explanation for some of the phenomena.
We can't let you go without talking a little bit about Fawlty Towers. At least I can't, because I think it's one of the greatest.
I don't want to talk about Fawlty Towers.
Yeah, but you know what? I mean, it's not all about you, is it? I mean, I can ask you about Fawlty Towers.
Well, you can talk about Fawlty Towers.
Okay.
Has done it all afternoon. So
what kind of a name is Wally, didn't he? Is it an anagram?
No. It's just Arabic. I take it, Arabic's not great.
No. I tried to learn it once. Yeah.
Really?
Well, there's about four H's and two K's or something. There's so many sounds in the back of the
throat. Do you know what John is in Arabic?
What?
Yahya. I bet you can't say that either.
Yahya.
This is compelling television.
It's more interesting than Fawlty Towers.
Well,
anyway.
I don't think it... Here's the question I want to ask you.
Well,
of all the comedy you've seen sort of lately, this century, the last, are there any ones that you look at and you go, I see Fawlty Towers imprint on that? I see Fawlty Towers in what they're doing?
That's a very interesting question. I don't think so.
Really?
Well, Fawlty Towers is a farce.
Yeah.
You know? Mm. I don't know. Americans don't know the word, but I think the Brits and the Aussies know farce. And it's a kind of comedy that I've always loved because it's played at a slightly higher level of intensity than ordinary comedy. And because of that extra energy, it gets the biggest laughs.
So not The Office or anything?
Yes,
like
but
that?
That's a slightly distance because it's a camera on the fly, what do they call it, eye on the wall, fly on the wall stuff, which distances it slightly. Yeah. I think it's very funny, but it's just a different type of comedy. I wouldn't call that fast because also the point about Fawlty Towers is the scenes are very long. They're not short.
Yeah. Well, thank you for letting me ask that question.
Yeah. Not at all.
I'm glad we got there.
And how do you say John in Arabic?
Yahya. That's close. You did pretty well.
Pretty good.
There you go. You'll be speaking Arabic by the end of the night.
My family name is Cheese. You know that, do you?
Yes, I do.
It could be Yahya Cheese.
Yahya Cheese. I mean, it's got a real ring to it.
Yeah.
If you would like tickets to an evening with the late Yahya Cheese... available now. Go buy them before it's too late, obviously. This will be fantastic to watch. Head to our website for details. In the meantime, would you please thank John Cleese?